At Fraunhofer IKTS, the entire value chain of solid-state batteries are covered. Oxide solid electrolytes for lithium and sodium solid-state batteries are manufactured in wet chemical processes. Smaller approaches on a gram scale can be realized in lab. Scale synthesis of several kilograms per batch are produced in our pilot plant. Suitable reactors with volumes of over 20 liters are available for individual applications. The formed gel of the solid electrolyte is dried and calcinated in air. During the temperature treatment, the ionic conducting crystal structure of the solid electrolyte is formed and a colorless powder is obtained. Particle size distribution can be adjusted to optimize shrinkage during sintering. Particle size of less than 1 micrometer can be achieved in powder ball, treater or counter jet grinding. Scaled batch sizes of several kilograms are covered. Cathode active materials are produced by spray drying. The continuous process also allows the granulation and surface coating of the cathode active materials. Varying the reactor size enables synthesis on a gram scale as well as technical scale of up to 100 kilograms. Electrodes and separator tapes are produced by tape casting or extrusion. All the following applications are carried out under drying room conditions. For tape casting processes, a slurry is produced consisting of ceramic powders, solvents, plasticizers and dispersants. Optimized mixing processes allow agglomerate-free processing of the materials. The slurry is deposited on the current collector or polymer films via doctor blade with a layer thickness of less than 100 micrometer. Extended tape casting systems on a pilot plant scale enable easy scaling of the process. The tapes are then calendared or hot laminated so that multi-layer system combining current collector, electrodes and separators can be manufactured. Another technique for composite cathode is in kneading mixing devices. This process could be done under wet or complete dry conditions without solvents. The tape is prepared in a lamination step using the calendar to desired thickness. As pilot scale process, the extrusion process is used. The tapes for oxide solid state batteries are punched and debinded at low temperature. The samples are then sintered at temperature of up to 1000 degrees. Various furnaces on a technical scale are available for this purpose. The atmosphere can be varied between air, nitrogen, oxygen or vacuum. Sintered separator and electrode tapes with a thickness of 60 to 100 micrometer are obtained. An alternative sintering method for oxide or hybrid systems is the cold sintering process. Cold sintering enables energy efficient sintering of ceramic materials and composite at temperature far below conventional sintering temperature. The materials are infiltrated with an additive solution and cold side inside a pressing tool. The low sintering temperature during cold sintering therefore also enable the co-sintering of materials such as solid electrolyte and active materials, which would react with each other at conventional temperatures. This allows stacks of anode, separator and cathode to be sintered in a single co-sintering process. The tape cast starting components infiltrates with the additive solution are stacked on top of each other and installed in the tool. The result after cold sintering is a ceramic cell stack between two metallic conductive foils. A wide variety of ceramic powders can be cold sintered for basic investigation, material properties and to optimize process parameters. The powder mixed with different additives are filled into the tool and covered with special separating foil. For the actual sintering process, the materials are then pressed into a hot press as temperature ranging from 100 to 400 degrees and pressures of up to 600 megapascal. Cold sintering allows ceramic pellets and films to be produced with densities well above 90% of the theoretical density. For the preparation of the electrochemical analysis, several gloveboxes with integrated systems can be used. Among them, the PVD chamber with sputtering functions allow the coating of solid electrolytes with electrodes, but also thin conductive films or metallic interlayers can be applied. For the characterization of materials and cells, different experimental setups are available. in a so-called PAT core cell, as shown here, oxidic materials like lithium and sodium solid electrolytes can be investigated at defined pressure of up to 15 MPa. Both pressure and temperature can be read out during the measurement and directly correlated with the electrochemical processes. This is especially interesting for contact area and nucleation studies. Other types of cells were developed for the investigation of samples at high pressures, especially for thiophosphates and halides. The filled-in samples are studied at a fixed operation pressure of up to 100 MPa. Usually, the ionic conductivity of materials, as well as the cycling stability and rate capability of full and half cells are tested. The comp drive setup allows similar studies varying operation pressures and temperatures. In addition, many other setups like pouch cells can be manufactured and studied depending on the research focus. For the characterization of the cells, a number of temperature chambers and channels are available, including 40 channels of impedance spectroscopy experiments. Feel free to contact us.